The Hopkinton High School National Honor Society welcomed in over 100 new members. To get in, students must have a cumulative GPA of at least 3.5 and be willing to volunteer their time to help the school and the community.
But what kinds of traits make up good character? Good character has an intangible definition that is almost impossible to describe. The students at HHS pinpoint exactly what the meaning of good character is by their words, behaviors, and actions. Good character at HHS is when students say thank you to their teacher every time they leave their classroom. It is giving up your seat surrounded by your closest friends at lunch to sit with a student that may be alone. It is the uproar in the football bleachers when a cheerleader everybody knows and loves overcomes her challenges to show up appropriate. It is picking someone up from who's parked in Kayla in the winter so they don't have to walk 3/4 of a mile across what feels to be like an Arctic tundra. It is the willingness of students to show up to school at 6:45 a.m. to make it to a before school meeting, even though it requires sacrificing precious minutes of their sacred. The definition of good character is evident from the extra effort the students put to make HHS a better place. The attributes of the people here today are what the whole student body of HHS admires and mimics. Without the students sitting in front of you, Hopkinton High School's reputable character would not possess the strength that it has today.
The time I felt most like a leader was not when I had the most sets of eyes focused on me, but instead when only one set of eyes were fixed upon me. It was when I was teaching a 14-year-old to swim. Now, I grew up almost drowning in various bodies of water. Therefore, I learned how to not drown in various bodies of water. But Unique, my camper, she had never even gone swimming before. So, understandably, she was as nervous as someone who's afraid of the water would be when we told her we were going on a boat to the middle of a pond to jump off and go swimming. She slid into the water very cautiously and was clutching onto the side of the boat for dear life. When she finally let go and instead followed me into the wide open water, imitating my crude doggy paddle, I looked back and saw a smile spread across my face and hers. Then I did a double take and realized that her smile was more of a, oh my goodness, type of stare. I've never felt like more of a leader. That's what leadership is. It's empowering others. It's passing on a passion, teaching skills, and providing a better example for someone else to follow. So as you all join NHS, I wish for you to discover your own unique. I hope you continue the leadership you've displayed thus far to earn your spot here tonight, and I can't wait to see you all further your passions and discover your own individual example that proves to you what it means to be a true leader.
The fourth and final pillar of the night is service. This pillar, I believe, stands out from the rest because it is a quality that forces someone to go beyond his or herself. It shows how these individuals share their time to help those in need, to raise money, and to organize events. This pillar shows that individuals help make a difference in this community. My heart grows as I watch these people benefit from the service I and many others have provided them. Whose heart couldn't swell when a person in need takes their hand and goes for theirs and says, thank you for all that you've done. I am truly grateful. Or how can someone be happy when they see all the smiling faces at the event that they put together? It's always great when people are marveling at decorations that you put up too, because you can gladly say that you made them all and make it so compliment. But in all seriousness, seeing the appreciation and joy in people's faces that I have helped put there causes my heart to grow, and I know many of my fellow students here share the same feeling with me. So when you start thinking about how many hours we ask of you to do for National Honor Society, just remember how good it feels to help others and see their smiling faces. It is really worth it.
On behalf of the National Honor Society, it is our pleasure to award Mr. Hanna as an official honorary member of NHS and gift him with this pin and certificate representing his position.
Oh, my mother will be so proud that I finally was pinned in the National Honor Society as one of the top performing districts in the state of Massachusetts. And we think about Massachusetts as one of the top performing districts in the United States of America. And we think about the fact that if Massachusetts public schools were a nation, we would be one of the top performing nations in the world. We are literally looking at a very small group of the top performing students in our entire globe. There's 7 million of us, and you sit in a very small group of our very best and brightest. And so we're looking at you because we need you. We need you to be our leaders. when you did consider yourself in a position to move our world to the 21st century. With that understood, I thought I would share, that is worthy of a clap. I agree with that. I have five quick pieces of advice. They're very simple. But because you've already shown this scholastic ability, it's important that you fill your soul with these pieces of advice to do the great work that we need you to do. Work hard and be honest. Your success is like a marathon. There will be many moments in which you're given an opportunity to take the shortcut, or tell a small fib, to get the deal done, to get a quick raise. Don't be tempted. Grit, honest, hard work, has always been and will continue to be the only way to get to success.